set of speakers. The first one is János Szendivarga from NextEnt, who are the organizer of this event. So thank you again. And there you go.
Okay. So hello, everyone. So you have heard my name is János Szendivarga. I work for this company who put this awesome conference together. And it's a pleasure for me to be here and on the stage. So a little story about me. I am the head of the innovation department of this company. And this innovation department called NextEnt Innovation. And this department is responsible for new products, new technologies. We are trying out new things, and we are trying to fit it into our core business. And this conference is also a new thing to put into our core business. And so if you have a good idea which can be fit into our core business, you can contact me here around or you can reach me after the conference in somewhere here in the near. So you can contact me on Twitter as well. So I will talk about graphs because in graphs I trust. So I am the big fan of graphs and graph databases. So let's talk about the big data challenges. Since we have in a big data conference, that means you have to hear the definition of big data. Everybody is talking about big data. Everybody is talking about V's, velocity, la 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 la, all the stuff. So that means we have data. So we have data. Data is the fingerprint of our business. So the properties of our data are similar than the properties of our business. So the more complex data we have, the more complex business we have. So there is nothing new here. So it's a complete mess. So the traditional relational databases are not able to store and process this data the way we use, because we have business and our business is data driven. Our business should be real time, and all the things around us are connected. So we have connectedness. So we are trying to connect things, Internet of Things, people, social networks, and we would like to connect into the network every piece of thing which has at least one wire or at least two parts. So that's why we have business, and we need the answers in real time, because there is no time to wait for a answer, because we lost our customers. So we have the technology, and the task of the technology is to fill the gap between our data and our business. So you have already known this gap theorem. That means we have technologies, we have databases, but we have limitations too. So we have constraints like the gap theorem, like the consistency, availability, and partition tolerant. You can pick two out of the three. So not a complete solution for all the problems. And that's why we have polyglot architecture, which means we use the right tools for the right task, and we have many, many technologies in use in our company. So there are a lot of companies who are dealing with big data, services, products, infrastructure. So it's still a young market, but there is a big hype around this. So you saw these pictures In the morning, this is the big data landscape. So the big data landscape 3.0, it's pretty new, contains all the companies who are dealing with big data. So there are 523 companies on this landscape, and you should choose one or two or three or some which best fits your business and your data. So we have the graph databases here in the 3.0 version. There is an earlier version of this picture, the big data landscape 2.0, but that picture is so 2015. So in that picture, the infrastructure has only one block for NoSQL databases, and the graph databases were in that category, and now they have a separate subcategory. So that means the graph databases are coming, and you should think about them. So why graphs? Graphs about connectedness. I already mentioned the business is about connectedness, and our data has complexity, and the complexity is the function of different things like the size. This is the volume V from the 5 or 3 V, and we have structured, semi-structured data, and we have connectedness, which means our data and our entities are connected together somehow, and we should explore the way they connected, because the real business value is in these connections. So the graphs are good where we have a lot of connection or relationship. So these are the typical use cases, the business situation where you can use the graph databases. One is the real-time recommendation. It's not a good approach to calculate some recommendation during the night, because the users want to get things when they are online, and they would like to get it in real time. So you have to calculate the recommended items in real time. So in recommendation systems, when you want to recommend based on collaborative filtering, where the recommendation is based on other users' behavior, you have to use graph databases, because they are quick and they can travel your graph quickly. So just think about the Spotify, Netflix, all the content recommendation engines. Fraud detection is about connectedness too. It's hard to find the fraud rings in a situation. So if you think about the insurance market, there are a lot of bad guys behind the scenes who are trying to make complex relationships to hide the business they made and to get the money from the insurance companies. So there are fraud rings, and the graph databases performs well in this scenario too. So master data management, nothing new. Our data or devices or services, it's a big graph. So this is another typical use case scenario where we can use graphs. So network and IT operations, they are networks. So network means things connected together. So that means it can be represented in a graph. Social networks, you have already heard about them. So identity and access management. It's a small area where the graphs are used nowadays, but if you think about the security concern of different things, Internet of Things area, you should deal with the complex network, and you should deal with the complex access management too. So this is another area where the graphs are good. And of course, graph-based search also an area. So that was the things I think about the graphs, where they perform well. And let's see what the market researchers, companies say. So Forrester, they said graph analysis is the true killer app for big data. That means you can use the graphs for analytics purposes, and it helps us to understand our data, because our data is like the human brain. I think we have a lot of data, big data, and we can use or only a small percent of it, like the human brain, and we can learn a lot if we get deeper understanding of things, how to get together. So Forrester said that, and the other interesting things they said. 25% of the enterprises will be using graph databases by 2017. It's not a future things. After 6 months, we will have 2017. So you should think about the graph databases. So, and the other source of the market research companies, Gartner. So graph analysis can be the differentiator for companies who are thinking that they are data driven. So, and one more thing, by 2018, 70% of the organization will use graph databases. At least in a pilot project or a proof of concept project. So that means the graphs are eating the world. They are coming, and a lot of companies now using graph technologies, not exactly the one vendor database I will show you, but graphs. So I will talk about Neo4j. Why use Neo4j? So this is based on the Neo4j.com. So this will be a bit marketing language. So I will try to translate it to engineering language. So why we use Neo4j? Because it's the best and the first. So that means they are the market leader. So that's true. They have a huge community. So 2 million downloads are there so far from the Neo4j community edition. It's a huge number. And if you see the Stack Overflow, GitHub, etc., then you can see the community is very active. So there are more than 100,000 tweets in a month about Neo4j, and there are meetup groups around the world. There are 50,000 people in different meetup groups, and we have a meetup group here in Budapest too. So a little thing Is the performance. They said it's high performant, of course. So the 3.0 version is pretty new. 2 weeks ago they present the new features of this database in London, and they said there is no software limit anymore in this database. So before that we have some limitation, but now they said they solve it, so you can put a lot of data into it without software limitation. So, and they have native graph storage, which means this database is not about to represent the graphs and map it to a relational tables or database. This database is about to store the graphs in their native format. So that's why they are high performance. So the fifth thing is it's easy to learn. I could learn it, so it's proven. So. And I get certified, so I think it's easy to learn and easy to use. I will show you if you are interested in a quick introduction training. You can implement recommendation engines in 1 day, so from the scratch. So I don't know what it means in marketing language. It's rock solid, so and easier than ever to load your data into Neo4j. That's true, because 5 years ago there was no way to load your data into Neo4j, so that's true. And it's whiteboard friendly, so that means if your marketer guy or your sales guy trying to translate the business needs to a technical guy, they are drawing on the whiteboard, and usually they are drawing graphs. So you can use it as a data model. You have to optimize it, and you can use it exactly in the format that they draw. So the last on this list, this technology is good for enterprises and for startups too, and for non-profit projects too. So that means you have the enterprise grade monitoring, scaling, blah, 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 and you have license for startups if you want to make a movie recommendation mobile app or a chatbot. So let's see the enterprise part. So the first question usually, does Neo4j work with something? Usually it's about languages, programming languages like Java, PHP, Go, I don't know, whatever. They have a very good factory support with a new binary protocol, so it can be very fast, and you can use in any language which are present on the horizon. So sometimes it checked. Other questions are about frameworks, like Spring framework, if you think about Java. Yes, the Spring framework is supported. There are a lot of community projects, so if there is no official support, the community can solve that problem. So you have deployment support for Docker, you have a lot of different frameworks. And the other question is usually, does it work with HDFS, Hadoop, Spark? So to be true, they can work with them, with that databases, but that's called polyglot architecture. So you should use the right tool for the right problem. That's a dogma, and everybody should think about it that when design the data architecture. So a typical data architecture is like this. We have a graph database cluster here. which is about recommendation, for example, real-time recommendation. But in a typical enterprise architecture, we have relational databases, NoSQL databases, Hadoop, and we have some bulk analytics. So we have a lot of different product, and we should use the right one. So this is about the enterprise, and I would like to talk about a bit non-profit projects. So the most connected data set, I think you read in the newspapers, for example, recently, is the Panama Papers. They are trying to discover the connection between the data points, like the companies, the guys, the shareholders, the different addresses. So it's a big connected data set. They contains a lot of nodes, more millions. They have a lot of relationships, people, organizations. So it's very critical to understand this connected data set. So that means you can download the public data set. The public data set contains only the public information, like company registration data. So this is not contains the scanned passport and emails and all the stuff they have in the investigation. But you can have this data set on your PC in 20 seconds. So that means you can discover the connection between the different data points. And this tool is a data exploration tool. It's something like Tableau or ClickU. It's a data exploration tool for your data, and it's a tool, it's called Linkorius, which is for explore the connection between the different entities, companies, officials, and countries. So this is an area where the journalist can use the database, the graph database, efficiently to discover your secret insights. So if you think about business, that's a real value, the secret insights in your data. So it's a good project, and if you want to see it, you can do it now. So it's not a complex thing, so you can easily start to know Neo4j with this data set. There is another interesting project. Since this conference is the Big Data Universe, there is a project about the universe. So you all know László Barabási Albert, who is a professor of network science, and he has a laboratory where they are dealing with network science, which means they are dealing with graphs. So they made a graph model of the universe, so the cosmic web. So they made a visualization. They use three different graph model to represent the cosmic web. And you can see the different universes, how they connect it together. So you can see that universe visualization on that website, but you can download the data and you can import it into a graph database, and you can use it to discover your data. So that means graph databases are good for explore the complex connected data set. And I think the universe, it's a complex thing. So I would like to summarize my speech. In the era of big data, you should focus on connect your data, not just collecting them, because in the morning you have heard that 60% of the big data project will have a failure because no real value out of it. So you should concentrate on the connections. So if you want to get to know about Neo4j, you can come our meetup 2 weeks from now in Ustream. You can find the meetup group if you search for Neo4j Budapest on meetup.com. So that's all I wanted to tell you. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Janos. We have a few minutes for questions. Does anyone has any questions? Now is the time.
Do you have any practical experience in the scale out or the scalability of Neo4j in several nodes?
Practical experience? Personally, I don't have. But if you think about the CAP theorem, about consistency and availability, the graph databases are good. But they are not so partition tolerant. That means you should have replication, and that's why in enterprise environment they have an active master node and several slave nodes. So that's the practical way to use in cluster environment the Neo4j. But for this you should buy the enterprise license, and only a few hundred companies bought this enterprise license. They are top 500 companies in the US, so like eBay, Walmart, and so on. So and about one node environment, I think, and you can deploy it to Amazon, for example. I think there are installations where a few hundred million nodes are present, but the number of nodes doesn't represent the complexity, because you should deal with the relationships. But I think you should use the graph databases for analytical purposes, and you should extend your solution with some massive graph processing tools, for example Spark or Hadoop. So that's all about this topic. So
anyone else? And thank you again.